Another area where you could possibly do a little bit of backbiting, which could classify as such, is when you are trying to describe someone to explain to somebody else. For example, if I have a friend who happens to be a little on the chubby side, and I need to tell another friend of mine that you have to go and meet him at the train station, I am trying my best to explain to him that, you know, he wears glasses, he has this kind of hair, he is like this, he is fair-skinned, so on and so forth. But the main characteristics I am leaving out, that he is chubby or he is fat. So if I was to just say that, that would help him in identifying that particular person. Or if we say that the person is blind, he would be wearing glasses and be carrying a white stick, or he's only got one leg, or so on and so forth. So in such a situation, just to describe the person and not to mock the person, it is permissible to do so. But you cannot certainly do it in a mocking manner. Another area where it is permissible is when someone who sins openly and his sins are not secret from anybody. He's a public sinner. So it is okay to talk about his public sins which are known to everybody. For example, a person who openly drinks. You can talk about an incident where you met him and he was found drinking such and such and something happened. So that would be alright. But if he's a secret drinker, it is not for you to reveal his sins. And we will inshallah talk about why it is not okay for you to do so. So again, mentioning somebody's secret sins is not allowed, because when we talked about the definition of backbiting, we said that it is something that is disliked by your brother. You say something about him which he does not like. So obviously a public sinner would not mind if his sin is again publicized. Similarly, when we're talking about the sins of the tongue, one of the other sins that actually immediately pops up is lying. And we know that it is a great sin in Islam. Even exaggerating, deception, or fabricating stories, or bending the truth, these are all things which are not allowed in Islam. It is not only bad for that Muslim, but it is also bad for the image and the reputation of Islam. Because when a person knows that these Muslims are liars, then it puts a bad image on Islam itself. But again, like backbiting, there are special circumstances which have been mentioned when it is okay to lie. And there are three conditions which the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, has mentioned. The first one being that when a man speaks to his wife to please her, he may use a diplomatic approach. For example, if she has prepared something for him, worked all day preparing something, yet that food is burnt, he can say the food is amazing. He does not have to say, oh, what garbage is this, you know. So in order to not dishearten her, he can be a little diplomatic in his approach. The other is to tell a lie at the time of war, when your life or the life of others depends on it. If you have been captured and the enemy is torturing you and trying to ask you information of where your partners are hiding, you can lie in that situation as well. Or for example, when you need to reconcile two or three or four people who have had some kind of trouble between them or some kind of animosity. You can go to one person and say, look, you have got to go to him because he's now actually talking good things about you. Whereas he might not be talking good about that particular person, but just to get them together and to sit together, it is okay to do so. So these conditions again have been made very clear for us. Anything outside of this would come under the category of sin, of great sin as a matter of fact. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in Surah At-Tawbah chapter 9 verse 119, O you who believe, have fear of Allah and be among the truthful. So we are asked as Muslims that if you have the fear of Allah, be truthful as well. Truth in your dealings with others and truthful also to yourself. Do not be a hypocrite. If you say you are a Muslim, then be a practicing Muslim. Because one of the greatest sinners in Islam is a hypocrite. According to a hadith of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, he mentions that I guarantee a house in the middle of paradise for the one who leaves off lying, even if it is in a joking manner. That the person who just stops lying altogether, not even in a joking manner, he is guaranteed a house in paradise. These are the words of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. So you can imagine the importance of speaking the truth. You are guaranteed a place in paradise if you do so. Even don't lie, even in a joking manner. According to another hadith mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari, the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, a person lies and lies until he is written with God as a habitual liar. So he is not trusted in the dunya and he is not trusted in the akhirah. And a person tells the truth and truth and truth until he is written as a sadiq, that he is the truthful one. And he is respected both in the dunya and in the akhirah. So these are again some of the merits of a truthful person in Islam. Now again, one of the other common things that we find is often cursing others, abusing others, which is again obviously a great sin in Islam. And it is also a sin on two accounts. First of all, it is a sin to swear by anything else except Allah. And we see nowadays that it is becoming a habit, particularly in our part of the world, that people often swear about their children, or they say, I swear upon my children or my life, or I swear upon X, Y, and Z, and they will swear upon everything else except Allah. Whereas the only person or the only being that you can swear upon is none other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Swearing upon anybody else apart from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would be a sin. And then it is also sinful to curse and abuse other Muslims and other fellow human beings. As it is mentioned in Surah Al-Hujurat, chapter 49, verse 11, O you who believe, let not a group mock another group. It may be that these are better than they, nor should women mock other women. It may be that these are better than they. Do not taunt one another, nor call one another by nicknames. It is an evil thing to be called a bad name after faith. Those who do not repent are the unjust. So it has been made very clear not to call each other by nicknames in trying to hurt them, in trying to tease them. That's not permissible at all. What is permissible, as a matter of fact, is, for example, if you know, if the person knows and if everybody else knows that it is a joke, and if the person who you are talking to does not mind being called that. For example, if a very big and muscular person walks in and you say, hello Tiny, how are you? Everyone knows that he is obviously not Tiny. So in that scenario, it is permissible to use this kind of nicknames in a joking manner, where it is obvious to everybody else that it is clearly a joke. Then another thing which we find a prohibition for in Islam is just random vain talk. When you're talking about nothing special in particular, or when you are engaged in showing off about this or that, that you know I have this property and you start talking on about it, or you know I have that and you start talking on about it. This is also not acceptable in Islam. We are advised to think before we speak, taking time to ask oneself the following questions. Will this saying of mine please Allah? Will this saying of mine bring me closer to Allah? Does this saying reflect obedience to Allah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in Surah Kaf, chapter 50, verse 18, not a word does he or she utter, but there is a watcher by him ready to record it. Every single word that you utter from your mouth is being recorded by an angel who is sitting on your shoulder taking account of every single thing you say. So it then becomes of utmost importance of whatever we speak, it should be good speech. Nothing bad, nothing useless, nothing garbage. If a Muslim ever feels uncertain, he should keep quiet rather than risk saying something which will contradict Islam and will be displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now this does not mean that a person cannot engage in a casual conversation, but rather that you should guard your speech and choose your words very carefully. This is the quality of a wise man or a wise woman, that he chooses his words carefully. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah Al-Mu'minun, chapter 23, verses 1 to 3, the believers are successful who in their prayers have khushu, meaning they have the fear of Allah in their prayer, and those who refrain from vain talk. They do not indulge in petty, useless, vain talk. These are the successful believers also.